I'm Dr. Chaitali Pawar from Department of Pharmacy, Government Polytechnic, Jalgaon. Today we discuss about recording of transaction. Learning outcome of this session, after watching this video, you will be able to recall definition of bookkeeping, double entry bookkeeping system, explain type of account and book of original entry, and record business transaction in journal. Bookkeeping, the science and the art of systematically and correctly recording of all transactions which involve the transfer of money or money worth is called bookkeeping. While double entry bookkeeping system, it is based on the principle that every transaction has twofold aspect, a giving aspect and a receiving aspect. The left hand side denoted DR, that is debit side, while the right hand side, that is credit side, denoted by CR. The principles of double entry bookkeeping system. First principle, the receiver is debited with monetary value of whatever he received, while the giver is credited with monetary value of whatever he gives. And the third rule, every debit entry require a credit and credit require a debit, that is vice versa. Types of account. Account is mainly divided into three main classes. An account is a formal record of all transaction related to changes in a particular item. Transactions of this similar nature, these are brought together at a one place in a book, that is called ledger. So this account, it is of three types: personal account, real account and nominal account. Personal account, it deals with individual person, firm, company and institution. For example, account of Mr. Deen Dayal, account of Messer Dev Medical Hall and account of Delhi University. So these are the some example of personal account. Second, real account. Real account, these accounts are maintained to deal with the transaction related to building, cash, furniture, land, machinery and stock. Third account, nominal account. These accounts are generally called fictitious account and these accounts are maintained to deal with discount, insurance, rent, wages, salary, cost of stationery item, interest, commission and amount spent on advertisement, while the profit or income of business is also included under the nominal account. To summarize, it can be said that there are three types of account, that is the personal account, real account and nominal account. So these are the three rules to make the entries in the book of account. For example, in case of personal account, on a debit side, the receiver, and on a credit side, the giver. While in case of real account, what comes in on a debit side, what goes out on a credit side. Then in case of nominal account, all expenses and losses on debit side, and all gain and income on a credit side. Book of original entry. These are the book for account in which a transaction is recorded for first time from the source document. Later on, the transaction from these books are transferred to ledger. Book of original entry is mainly classified into three classes. First one is journal, second cash book, and the third one is other day book. कैश बुक इट इज अगेन सब क्लासिफाइड इंटू फोर मेन क्लासेज, सिंपल कैश बुक, टू कॉलम कैश बुक, थ्री कॉलम कैश बुक एंड पेटी कैश बुक, वाइल अदर डे बुक लाइक परचेज बुक, सेल बुक, परचेज रिटर्न बुक एंड सेल रिटर्न बुक. सो टूडे वी स्टार्ट विथ द फर्स्ट टाइप ऑफ बुक ऑफ ओरिजिनल एंट्री, दैट इज जर्नल. जर्नल दिस इज द बुक ऑफ ओरिजिनल एंट्री. हियर ट्रांजेक्शन आर रिकॉर्डेड एज एंड वेन दे टेक प्लेस. द ट्रांजेक्शन फ्रॉम दिस बुक आर पोस्टेड इन अ लेजर. दिस इज द फॉर्मेट फॉर जर्नल. जर्नल मेनली कंसिस्ट ऑफ फाइव कॉलम. फर्स्ट कॉलम फॉर डेट. सो हियर एंटर द डेट ऑफ ट्रांजेक्शन अलॉन्ग विथ ईयर एंड मंथ. सेकेंड कॉलम पर्टिकुलर. अ ब्रीफ एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ ट्रांजेक्शन इज कॉल्ड नैरेशन इज गिवन इन अ पर्टिकुलर कॉलम एंड इट इज नेसेसरी टू राइट नैरेशन बिलो ईच ट्रांजेक्शन. थर्ड कॉलम LF, that means the page number of ledger is given when the transaction is posted to ledger. Till that column remain blank. Fourth column debit. The amount to be debited to the account is written close to the line in a particular column and the word DR is written in front of debit entry. Last column, the amount to be credited to the account is written a few space away from margin and the word to is written before the credit entry. So this is the format for journal. Next one is rules of generalizing. In double entry bookkeeping system, two accounts are affected during account. One account is debited and other account is credited. So here are some rules which are made for generalizing. First one is personal account. Debit the receiver and credit the giver. For example, pay rupees 500 in cash to Ram. In this statement, firstly identify two accounts. So first account is Ram and second account is cash account. So pay rupees 500 in cash to Ram. So here Ram is receiver, so that's why Ram account is debited while the cash account is credited. So write down the narration below cash account, that is cash paid to Ram. Like that, solve this second example yourself. Rupees 500 is received from Mohan. Okay. Then second, real account. In case of this account, what comes in is debited and what goes out is credited. For example, rupees 2000 is paid in cash on the purchase of furniture. In this statement, first identify two accounts. So two accounts are furniture account and second one is cash account. So furniture, that means what comes in. So that's why the furniture account get debited with 200 rupees and the cash account is credited with 2000 rupees. Third account, nominal account. Here all expenses debited and all income credited. For example, rupees 500 is given for salary. So here two accounts are salary account and cash account. Salary, that means expenses. So that's why salary account get debited and the cash account get credited. Then the fourth one is good. Good means all those items which any businessman buy it in order to gain profit on its sale. This good account is divided into four main categories for the purpose of making its entry into journal. Four types of good account: purchase account, sale account, purchase return account and sale return account. First account, purchase account. When any goods are purchased, then debit entry is made in a purchase account. That's why purchase account is always debited. Second account, sale account. When any goods are sold, then the credit entry is made in the sale account. Then purchase return account. If any purchase goods are returned, then it is called return outward. So that's why the purchase return account is always credited. And the last account, that is sale return account. If sold goods are received back, it is called return inward. So sale return account is always debited. So in this way, goods get classified into four main accounts: purchase account, sale account, purchase return account and sale return account. In case of capital account, the owner of business is always considered to be separate from his business. So that's why the capital account is on a credit side and the cash account is on a debit side. Then drawing accounts, when a businessman withdraw money from his business for personal use, then the account is debited in a drawing account and the cash account get credited. Then seventh rule, that is trade discount. Trade discount means the deduction of certain percentage from the quoted price. No journal entry is done because it is deducted from cash memo or invoice directly. For example, the good worth rupees 4000 are purchased at a trade discount of 5% for a cash. So here the purchase account and the cash account is there. So that's why the 5% amount is deducted from 4000, so it remains 3800. So this amount is directly comes on bill, so that's why there is no need for a separate entry. Then the last one is cash discount. It is an allowance which is made by the receiver of cash to the payer for the payment made before the due date. And here it is recorded at the same place where cash transaction is recorded. For example, the businessman buy goods for rupees 3600 and settle his account at a cash discount of 2%. So here two accounts, purchase account and cash account. And third account is also involved, that is discount account. So the purchase amount is 3600, but it is settled by giving a cash discount of 2%. So that's why from this price minus the 2% price, so it's remain 3528. And discount is 72 rupees. So in this way, like this, write down your transaction in a journal. So these are the some rules for generalizing. So here we solve this example. Enter the following transaction in a journal of Messer Radhika Medical Hall for the month of July 2000. So in this example, different transactions are given. So first, Mr. Lokesh Kumar started his business with a capital 1 lakh rupees. Capital, that means it required to start the business. So that's when it involve in a cash account or the capital account. So along with this example, second is brought furniture for the cash from Messer Modern Furniture. So identify which two accounts involve in it and then make the entry in a particular column. So here furniture account and the cash account is there. Then purchase the good for the cash. So two accounts are purchase account and cash account. Then paid trade expenses of rupees 25. So here trade expense account and the cash account, these two accounts are there. So in this way, identify the two accounts and also identify the debit side and the credit side of account. So finally, this type of format get arise, that is the journal of Messer Radhika Medical Hall. So here the debit side and the credit side is there. So in this way, you may solve this problem. Second one is opening journal entry. The entries which are made to start the new book are called as opening entry. The entries which are made to start the new book are called opening entries, and the debit opening balance of assessed and credit the opening balance of liabilities including capital also. For example, Mr. Rajat Mehra, a retail pharmacist, has the following assets and liabilities. So assets such as cash rupees 9000, then stock in trade, furniture due from Ram, due from Gupta, and the liabilities such as amount due to Hari, Surinder, and the loan from bank. So when we go for opening journal entry, at that time this type of entry should be there, that is cash account debited with 9000 rupees, then stock account, then furniture account, Ram account, then Gupta. So all are debited, while Hari account, then Surinder, loan from bank, and the capital account, all are credited. So in this way, these opening entries are also important. Then compound entry. If two or more than two business transactions are concerned with the same account and of the same date, then it is considered as a compound entry and it is recorded in a journal as a one entry. For example, on the 31st December 2000, rupees 4000 is paid as a salary and 800 as a rent. So this salary account is debited and rent account is also debited. So this salary and rent account, it is called as a compound entry, while the cash account is credited and the total, that is the sum of salary and rent account, is mentioned in a cash account. So in this way, this is the compound entry. Summary of this session. So in this session, we learn about the definition of bookkeeping, then principles of double entry bookkeeping system, then we observe the different types of account and different classes of main book of original entry such as journal, then cash book and other day book. So from these three types, here in this session we complete only the journal. Then last one is recording of transaction in a journal. So remaining part, that is the cash book and other day book, it will be seen in next session of this recording of transaction. So thank you very much. Hi guys.